sometimes not everything works. So you have to start eliminating things in the painting to get to a place that you're really happy with it and get to a better painting. So I'm going to show you how I do that in my process, in the pieces that I'm working on. And hopefully you'll be encouraged to do that and not be so afraid, because it's only paint. I just keep painting layers and layers until it gets to a point where I like it. And when I like it and feel good about it, then it's done. So I'm going to show you that. And thank you so much for following along with me and for subscribing and all the thumbs ups. I really appreciate it. And I felt bad I didn't show up last week, but that's kind of in my own head, I believe. So until next week, enjoy this week's video and make it a great week. Bye. Okay, so I'm gonna show you a very speeded up version of the origins of this piece. It was inspired by wallpaper that I found, and I loved the pattern and I loved the designs on it. So I cut it up along with some of my jelly papers and bits and pieces I have here in the studio is what I usually use in my art. And then I go in and negative paint around all of those things and kind of try to find my shapes that way of where I want the painting to go. And while I was really kind of happy with how this turned out, because it met everything I wanted blue and green and cream. And this series is gonna be titled In the Windowsill. So I'm wanting to create that in a more abstracted way. But with this piece, with the two pieces I'm gonna show you, I loved the way they looked. But it was mostly collage and how I laid down the artwork of somebody else, which, you know, it is something that's pretty common with us mixed media artists. But I liked it a lot, but I wasn't in love with it. So from here, I'm going to show you how I go about changing that up. Not being afraid to cover things up, because if it's not feeling right, it's never really going to feel right. So don't be afraid to go in, cover things up, and just take it from there, because eventually you will get to a place where you really are in love with it. And that's where you want to be. That's where you want to be with your artwork. So I hope you enjoy watching this, and I will talk you through some of it. Okay, now I'm gonna take this one, which I thought was done, but just to demonstrate, don't be afraid to cover stuff up. It's just paint. You're not gonna lose anything. So I wanna simplify and get rid of some things, and I'm just using my white up chalk paint. It's actually not white. The color is called Pale Ivory, and I was really happy with how these paintings were turning out. However, I just wanted something a little bit more abstracted. Let me get that line back. So this is just to show you, to demonstrate. Don't be afraid, just cover things up. And as you can see, I'm not being super careful with this. There's things in here I really like. And I don't mind if some of the texture shows up. I have a lot of texture in these pieces because there's a lot of things glued into them. And I may be going over this again with another color, but for now, I'm just mapping out where I want to go. There's some things I want to keep, like there's a little number 9 right there. And if I can keep that, I kind of like to, and maybe I'll just paint over it and pull it back up. I want to keep some of the colors underneath, peeking through, just to show the history of the painting. And work in between things. And you can see I'm not being super precise and super careful. It's not really my style. I like it to be loose and painterly. Clean my brush off. Come back in. And there's some words here that describe the apple. I might want to keep some of that. Obscure it out a little bit. And I kind of get the paint off my brush, and then we'll come back in and do a really soften up my line a little bit. Okay, believe it or not, I'm gonna lose all of this down here. Let's see, yeah, I'm gonna lose all of it. You can then leave little bits and pieces peeking through as you go along because maybe you're not quite sure of what you want to give up. And if you leave just the, you can come back and get rid of things later. I like a big flat brush like this Bright. This is a Bright. They're my favorite. They're squared off into shorter bristle. And I like them because they give me a lot of versatility. I can cover up a large area, or I can go in and just hit the edge and do some smaller areas. I can use the corner. Get into some tight spots. And again, I'm not looking to be really precise. Okay, this is where these pieces are ending up right now. I've eliminated things I don't want, that I don't think I need. There's a couple things I wish I had kept. Let me see if I can do something about that. I use my hand sanitizer for the alcohol content to remove paint. And let's see if that's gonna work. Might not. Maybe if I just let it sit for a minute. This is a really textured, these papers are very textured. It was a vinyl wall covering. So the paint has really worked its way into the texture. And actually, kind of like that. That might just be all I need. Just a little bit of pattern. I like that. This is a case of you never know how things are going to work out. That's just enough. That's just what I want. I still have the wallpaper that this came from that I originally used. And if I wanted to, you know, have something that had a little bit more pattern, like these two leaves on these guys right here, I could either paint it in. And I'm using this wallpaper because I like the texture and I like the thickness. Now, if I want a leaf in this area that's strong like these guys, I could just add that. Add it like that. Now, I typically don't like to necessarily cut things out, but in this case, and there's no way I'm tearing. I like to tear papers rather than cut them because I like a more organic edge. But I think in this case, since I can't tear this wallpaper, oh, see, that to me works pretty well. Maybe I can even do that. And now I've got two leaves that match this. I have a couple leaves that are obscured back. So I'm going to get these wet. Okay, so let's see. I've got those wet. One and maybe that and that. And take my matte medium, although I think gel medium is going to work better on these guys. Since the paper is so thick, the gel medium will work better. Okay, now I'm feeling like these guys match a little bit better. They both have areas where they're obscured. I'm liking it. So I'm going to continue on from here. And now I'm going to do something really crazy. Okay, so I put a little bit of a wash on this one, this piece. And the bottom piece, the bigger one, also has a wash on it. So let me show you what I just did. I literally just took some medium and I have a little bit of raw umber here. I'm gonna stick that there. And I just want to scrub it in. Let me overlap that a little bit so I'm not getting it on the piece below. But what that does is it's gonna collect in all the nooks and crannies. And it's gonna, a lot of the texture is gonna come up. The uneven edges that I have, like this is where paper has been added. So it's gonna fill in there, which I kind of like. Okay. And I'm going to go over this again with another color. Haven't decided which one yet. But I'll go back and lighten it up. And I just go back and forth like that. Liking that. Can you see how that, this was a tissue paper that was laid down at some point with paint on it, and I've gone over it a couple times, but now the cool texture shows up. Here was where I had a piece of the wallpaper glued down and it caught around the edges of that. I'm really liking that, really liking where these are headed. So yeah. So this is where these pieces ended up. This is where it started. And I was wanting more of me in there and less of just collage pieces. So I went in and I eliminated, process of elimination, and got rid of everything that I thought was just too busy. I went back over that cream with many layers of blues and different colors of blues. There's like six different layers on there, only to go back over it with the cream. But now it's not just cream, it's a much more layered, rich cream.